Sharp U Cyclone just came in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. And this is a this is definitely a product that everyone needs to pay a little respect to. You can really thank Heartland, who built the Cyclone here, for making today's toy hauler market really what it is. Now, unfortunately, I didn't get to this one before it got parked, so I can't have the rear tailgate down, but we'll still visit the garage area. But really, this was the first truly like purpose-built thing in its class. What their goal here was is to make something that fit into the luxury fifth wheel category, but it just happened to have a garage or utility area on the back. It wasn't necessarily a toy hauler so much as it was just a mover, a goer. Now, obviously, yes, it is a toy hauler, but the whole mindset around the build and design of this was different. Now, we do have a nice Onan Marquee Gold 5500 park-friendly quiet generator here. So if you are off the beaten path, you're okay. We've got amazing storage here. This is one of the very few fifth-wheel toy haulers, especially at its time, to have nice pass-through storage. And you see so many qualities, a lot of things you're going to see in this video, like the central vacuum. These are things that, again, belong to the, you know, luxury fifth wheel segment that didn't belong to really toy haulers. And these guys just looked at it different. And we always really watched this product grow. And it was really exciting for us when their designer behind the Cyclone moved over to design Jayco's Seismic fifth wheel toy haulers that you can find here at Haylett's. You know, you'll see a lot of the same mentality and attention to detail in those products. So we've got a big U-lounge or dinette slide out here. There's a little removable table you can toss down there if you want to turn that into a dining area. That can also be an additional sleeping space. And because the ceiling's so tall in here, they could put an extra big slide that gave them room for storage and big windows. And hey, why not add a skylight up here as well, just for extra light. All the original electronics and everything are present and accounted for. By and large, the near as I can tell by looking through this, the story that I can determine from it with my years of experience of looking at used RVs when they come in, it's like playing crime scene detective for campers. CSI for campers is what I call it. This thing looks like it was really well kept and well maintained and just not well used. They just didn't use it. I mean, I don't see where they really use this thing much at all. And that's probably the reason it's here. I can't find anything wrong with it other than the fact that it's in our driveway and not yours. You know, nice, again, luxury fifth wheel features like solid surface countertops. And I love the level exchange here. I'm a sucker for kitchen bar stools. If you've watched my videos, you know that. But good kitchen space. Now, they have purpose-built things here like the trash bin, the recessed stainless sink. Again, luxury fifth wheel features and a toy hauler. Way before that was cool to do. Now everybody does it. You can thank these guys for it. But good counter space and prep space. Now this slide over here has all your big appliances, 1, 2, 3, in the slide out off the floor plan. And they even included a big pantry right down the middle, so your campsite cook has lots of pantry space. And just like the skylight above the slide on the other side, we have both a skylight here and here, just tons of light pouring in. Amazing sound system in this too. This, if you're an audiophile like me, you'll really enjoy it. Now this is cool. This has a loft bunk with a dedicated little wraparound staircase up here. And it even has its own little dedicated entertainment center. Oops, let me get the beams out of the way. So you could throw a TV up there if you're so inclined. So this could be bunks, obviously, a sleeping space, but it could be an attic. It could be storage. And you can always pull that curtain, so there's a visual breakpoint there. So you're not going to feel like you're looking at totes in duffel bags being stored in your living room. I love the full pass-through vapor wall here. Now this has a fitted rug back here so that you, what is this? This is like, I gotta measure, this is like a 12 or 14 foot massive garage. I don't care what toy you got, it's gonna fit in here. This is big. Side mount ladder so you can get up to your roof for maintenance. Little detail stuff like this too, like when your toys are unloaded, this is designed, you can easily use this as like an extended living space or like a screen-in deck patio, because you do have the nice roll-down screen wall back here, which is great. You know, you can turn this into a true three seasons room with no bugs. But dedicated TV back here, we got our own little mini fridge back here, and I love the little transparent door on it so you can see what's in there. It's just, I don't know, that's cool. I like seeing that. Now this table actually flips up. It's built onto the wall, but it folds down out of the way, so it doesn't really stick out any further than this Happy Jack mount, which, by the way, I should point out, this does have the power bed and dual sofa lift down here. I didn't pull it down for this video. Now on the back side of the loft. You have great storage here. So this whole darn thing is about 1 foot deep storage. It's about 2 foot tall. You can put big stuff in there. And again, just extra little bar stools you can put around the little table over here to have your own little, you know, private picnic space. Very neat stuff. Just give you a quick panning view of the living room from the other direction, then we're gonna move onward. Might be a little short and sweet here, but this one tells its own story pretty well. I do love how this little island right here is neat because the mirrors and everything give it the sensory of being quite large. Central vacuum down here, by the way. But this walkthrough middle bath is really cool. So we've got a full stand-up shower that is tall person friendly. I tested it. It's tall guy approved. Tall guy tested, tall guy approved. Now, this window here does have a shade for privacy, but I love the look and the light and the space that it gives you right when you walk in. The bedroom up here, this is a true queen. So a true 60 by 80, so tall folks, once again, your feet are not going to hang off the bed. And just in case you forgot what kind of RV you own, they made sure they put it on the bedspread at night, just in case you forgot in the meantime. Third TV, still present and accounted for. So this, you know, you got TVs everywhere in this. This is a party entertainment thing. And I love the little side stand in there for your little phone charging station. That's a smart, smart decision. And storage in the bedroom of a toy hauler. This is something that toy haulers just... Frankly, toy haulers used to just suck at in the bedroom. They had no storage. So they put this extra big closet over here. Then this is a full-on storage slide-out. You see you've got the, you know, like shelving storage there. And that is, the rest of it is just all hanging closet space. This thing's awesome. It is very well equipped. It's been very well kept. It just needs a home. You know, little detail stuff too, like little stopper so that the handle doesn't punch through the door. Great stuff. And hey, you can get a great deal on it. If you're looking for a big toy hauler but you don't want a new price tag, I got a real sharp top end one here for you. So 800-256-5196, Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.